The Death Star was the crowning achievement of Imperial military might. The size of a small moon, it had enough raw firepower to destroy an entire planet. However, shortly after becoming operational, the Death Star was destroyed, allegedly by rebels, during an attack in the Yavin system. This is the widely known footage of the explosion of the Death Star. At face value, it might not look like much, but if you look closely, there is a suspicious anomaly that occurs. Watch again carefully. Do you see it? Now let's look at it upside down. Find it yet? How about upside down and in black and white? What the footage shows is a ring of unidentified material that is blasted outward before the actual explosion of the Death Star. Experts have stated that this can only mean the ring was a separate event and not possibly due to the supposed chain reaction caused by Skywalker's 1-in-a-million shot. They have also said that such a ring effect could only be caused by large explosive devices placed around the entire circumference of the Death Star. Notice that the ring material moves away at twice the rate of the actual Death Star material itself. Skywalker was able to make his odds-defying shot, and then escape from the Death Star before it exploded. At least, according to the official story. But hold everything for a sec. Consider the following transmissions intercepted during the battle. Did you catch that? Full throttle. So let's go back now and watch that again. So the proton torpedoes accelerating away from an X-Wing at full throttle couldn't cover the radius of the Death Star in the time it took the Rebel ships to travel the diameter of at least 3 Death Stars? That doesn't make sense. Did the torpedoes get lost on their way to the reactor? Or maybe they stopped off for coffee before moving on to their final destination? Regardless, the official Imperial explanation of the events surrounding the destruction of the Death Star does not stand up under close scrutiny. In fact, much of the evidence indicates a massive government conspiracy. For example, this is footage of the alleged rebel ships used in the attack. This was taken from a civilian research satellite orbiting Yavin. Imperial authorities tell us that this is an X-Wing. However, while bearing a striking resemblance to an X-Wing, it is not. This is how an X-Wing should appear. How could Imperial intelligence misidentify the ships used in the attack as X-Wings when they are clearly not? Perhaps the correct question is, why? It is well known that only the Rebel Alliance has access to the design plans stolen from Incom to make the X-Wing. So what are these ships, and where did they come from? When asked about this, representatives from Incom refused to answer due to galactic security. And this is only the tip of the cover-up.